still don't know how to wave when doing traditional art videos. I'm also in the middle of the sketch, but that doesn't matter. Today, we are here with the one, the only, grabby acrylic markers, extra fine. I have my only color sheet that I just did a few minutes ago, and we are going to be doing a little bit of a side project. This is kind of the concept version of the series, but like, that's only because I'm going to be doing these digitally at some point, but we're redesigning the main six for My Little Pony, and I really hope you guys do like this video. The rest of this video is going to be sped up for reference, but this part now I just wanted to talk and tell you guys what was going on, so let's get to it! Well, howdy do you there? It's voiceover mode! Hopefully you guys can hear the difference in audio quality. I have a very tiny microphone that I'm using right now to try and record audio. Hopefully it works and doesn't pick up anything else, because I do have something on right beside me right now. But yeah, video has been a hell and a half to make. I repeat, a hell and a half to make. For so many reasons, this video has been delayed, and because of it, I've delayed doing the rest of the My Little Pony redraw series, even though I have designs set up for like two more of the main six. But I'm telling myself that as of recording this video, this is gonna get uploaded tonight. I don't care if it doesn't get any traction or anything like that. I just want this uploaded and out of my hair. But anyways, let's talk about Pinkie Pie in this case. I didn't change a whole lot. Well, that's kind of a lie. We know how Pinkie Pie is initially designed, but I'm saying that I didn't change a whole lot because originally, a very long time ago on my page, I actually did redesigns of the main six. And ultimately, what I'm saying I didn't change much is that I didn't change much in accordance to that previous redesign that I did because I liked a lot of the choices I made in that redesign. I, like most fans of My Little Pony, am a very firm believer that Pinkie Pie is black. In my personal headcanon, she's a black Hispanic woman, but like, I just wanted to exemplify that within her design, because like, we already saw it with the hair, I just wanted to make it a little bit more known that she is a person of color. And it's not like super noticeable in these designs, at least. Like, the human head that you're gonna see once I get to the coloring stage is like the most we're gonna see about it on here. But I eventually will be doing an Equestria Girls redesign, like when I have the time to. Because generally speaking, I feel like the Equestria Girls should definitely be changed a little bit to suit more of like their personalities and characteristics. Because like, the fact that all of them were in skirts bothers me. Especially Rainbow Dash and Applejack. Like, I know they're girls and all that, but like, girls can wear pants. I have pants on right now. I got dungarees on. Girls can wear pants. You do not need to be representing every single feminine character with a skirt and a girly aesthetic. Like, Rainbow Dash, by all means, and Applejack too, are like some of the most feminine girls, but also are very masculine in design. But going back to the pony designs, I mainly wanted to use a lot of confectionery colors. I wanted to use browns and greens and purples and like all of these colors that you commonly would associate with sweets. That, and also to an extent, the grabby markers are a little bit kind of, not cornering, but I'm going to use the term cornering because I can't think of the right word. But that's kind of surprising considering there's only like 20 colors in the entire pack. I'm also going to spoil this here and now. There is going to be a digital speed paint version of the main six, like, after their traditional art videos start coming out. To be fair, I'm also debating whether or not I'm going to continue doing the traditional art format for at least the main six. I might just go and do all the digital formats and then do these videos as sort of, like, a post-op kind of thing. I don't know. Things are coming and going. This video has been general shit the entire time I've made it. But I wholeheartedly mean it when I say that this Ohuhu sketchbook that I have, not the one that's in this video, this is a Canson book, but I have this Ohuhu sketchbook that I got off the TikTok shop. It's also where I ended up getting this mic from, and from what I've generally worked with both of them, they're amazing. But like, this book has sparked something within me, because it's only like 6.9 by 6.5, which means that it's significantly easier for me to like make art in this. I will 100% be making like, not only just a review for this book, but I will also be doing like, forgetting words, but like a sketchbook review, that's what I'm gonna call it for the time being. Like, once I finish this sketchbook, we're doing that 100% because like, I just have to. And I've also bought two others, one in a slightly bigger size and then one that's the same size as this one. But the main reason that I'm bringing up this book is that, like, I think in the first 3 days, I made purely, I think, like, three, if not four, My Little Pony redesign drawings in full. And, like, they're fully colored and everything. And I even have, like, a photo that is My Little Pony related, but is not related to the redesign universe that I'm making and all that stuff. It's just me and two of my friends as ponies, which, like, one of them is a pony that they already had, and the other one belongs to a friend who doesn't have a pony sona. But I really just wanted to bring up that book because, like, I love Ohuhu products. Don't get me wrong, I'm a firm stan of Ohuhu products and all that shit. But this sketchbook is a lot better than I was expecting, and it has brought something visceral out of me that I just have little to no control over. And I'm going to fill this book a lot faster than I was ever expecting to. I mean, to be fair, the 6.9 by 6.5 only has like 30 pages. The other says it have a little bit more, but like, I'm gonna deck through this, and I'm gonna be making see my sketchbook video in the future once I finish it. That's not the right term, but you know what I mean if you've seen art YouTube at all. But now moving on to other things, I want to talk about a really small content creator that I found on this app that I feel like y'all should know because they're also an artist and they don't even have over 100 subscribers. And like, I don't like talking about subscribers a whole lot because I just generally don't care about subscribers and all that stuff, but like, the fact that they only have 81 subscribers, meanwhile I somehow managed to get over 100, completely baffles me because their art is super duper good and like, they deserve significantly more recognition. Like, the video that I found them on only has 122 views. Their name is Miley with a little smiley face using, I think, like a, not parentheses bracket, but the square version of the parentheses bracket has, like, the smile and all that stuff. I'm terrible at explaining things, I'm sorry. Actually, to be fully honest, I probably should make, like, an in-depth video of certain YouTube videos and pages and all that stuff that I feel like people should personally watch. I don't know if I'll actually do it. If anything, it might end up on TikTok or whatever. I have no idea. And I guess I can also, to an extent, update you because some things have happened. I don't know if in a previous video I said that I was in therapy, but I've been doing BetterHelp therapy for, I think, like, a couple of months now. And it has helped significantly with a lot of my previous issues that I've had. I don't talk about them a lot on here because I just don't have the time to, and I don't fully feel comfortable in doing so, but, like, I've definitely gotten a lot better from where I was in 2023 now that I'm in 2024, though there are still some difficult points and times. One of the really, like, big changes was just, like, I guess getting my shit together, generally speaking, because, like, there were a lot of things that I was just straight up not doing that I really should have been doing just for my own health. Like, I'm supposed to take vitamin D and iron gummies, like, every single day, and I'm supposed to take, like, two of them usually, and I was not doing that for the longest time, and now I understand why I was so grumpy and cranky. I was very much iron deficient and vitamin D deficient. There's also drinking water just in any capacity. I've gotten a lot better. I can now tolerate the taste of water without flavoring, though sometimes it is a little bit difficult for me to tolerate the flavor. But I've gotten into drinking water more, and I just don't understand how some people do it. Like, it baffles me that people can drink so much water today, because, like, everyone knows about the 8 ounces, 8 glasses, 8 days a week, or whatever that saying is. Basically, you're supposed to drink like 64 ounces at the very minimum, just in order to stay healthy. But with talking with my therapist, a thing that we learned is that ultimately the way that we gotta go about it is that for every like 2 pounds on your body, you have to drink 1 ounce of water, which means for me, a 300 pound individual, I have to drink like at maximum 150, but generally we've set the bar for like 80. And good lord, is it hard? I'm gonna say that full honesty, because like, I had to get a specific bottle. It's a Yeti bottle that's 26 ounces. I had to get that because I didn't have any super big bottles that I felt comfortable just bringing around with me all the time. And also, at the time, I ended up getting a 10 ounce Yeti bottle that I really like, and I just wanted another one in the same color. But like, I have to drink like at minimum 3 of those in a day. And for the longest time, it was so unbelievably difficult just trying to get down 2 of those in a day. I remember that like I had to pee so much. That's a whole other story, but like it was so difficult just like moving from 1 to 2 to 3. And now I can do it reasonably enough if I like space it out properly. I bring it to work, I bring it like when I go down to places, I just bring it everywhere. But like that's what I'm trying to talk about, and like things that I absolutely should have been doing, but just straight up weren't, because for me, what I was doing was just enough for like what I felt I needed for my body. And now I'm realizing I was not taking care of myself any way that I probably should have been. And like, it's still difficult now, but I'm getting significantly better with it. And I'm very happy that I've made these changes. My next change as of now is to try and get on a better diet. I'm gonna try yet again to like generally just fix my diet, because I realized that I eat way too much fast food, because with all the shit that's gone on in the world, we just don't really go food shopping like as much as we used to, because usually we used to do it every Sunday, and now we have to like normally plan it around like Wednesday or Thursday, so that way my mom and I can go. And even when we go, we don't often grab a lot of like super healthy foods, because both of us are working and we don't really always have the urge to cook. But I have a general idea of like what I want to do, and for the longest time I've been wanting to do this, I've been meaning to do this. There is a healthier recipe version of what's referred to as the chicken quesadilla that you can find at like Taco Bell. I have been craving that for literal ages, and they don't have it on the menu. You gotta order it online, and they don't even have it in Grubhub for some reason. I've been craving that for ages. I just have to keep getting chicken quesadillas whenever I go to Taco Bell. But I don't want to do that anymore. I want to make a healthy version of a chicken quesadilla that I can have at home. And I'm gonna teach myself how to cook that shit the best I can, if I'm able to. I've also recently gotten into the art of journaling, at least a little bit. I know it's a very juxtaposition transition that I'm going into, but I've been trying to get into journaling. I basically made my own personal journal, because in the past I bought a journal that was like pre-made and everything. All I'm gonna say is there is too much shit in there. I swear to God, there is way too much shit in there. That book in of itself personally became like a doodle book for me, rather than an actual like journal, and I'm realizing it's because there was just so much stuff that you had to keep track of that I just at the time really couldn't do, because a lot of it either didn't apply or I just didn't fall into the pattern of doing it frequently enough to like get hooked onto it. But now I actually like have more reasonable standards for like doing books like that, and I don't like beat on myself for not being up to date with everything. I just go and fill it into the best of my ability and I move on. And it also, like, I just generally like the aesthetic that I built for myself a bit more. And I kind of recommend that if you want to get into journaling, maybe try and like first look up references of like people's journaling if they do like their own custom journals. But also, like, I would say start with like making your own custom journals rather than buy one pre-bought, unless like pre-bought works for you a lot better. But I'd say if you want to and you have like the means, like if you're a stationery hoarder or whatever, go and make your own. Another thing that I can also like talk about a little bit more is that I've ultimately cut down a decent bit on my Squishmallow collection, which, like, I don't know if you guys know how severe it was. I think in total I had over 400, maybe even 500 if we fully count like the Squishfills and mini ones that I had. But like, I had a lot of Squishmallows. And due to some recent events that I don't know if I can actually say on here, I'm just gonna say it's PAL time. But what's happening in PAL right now ultimately made me realize that I do not want to support Squishmallows as a company, because unfortunately they are pro is in this situation rather than pro PAL, and I just don't want to stand for that. And also they've been caught stealing things from like other creators and stuff, primarily Squishables, which are pro PAL in this situation. That, and also to be fair to myself, it was getting really hard to just move around my room with how many Squishmallows and general plushies that I just had. Like, multiple spots in my room on the floor were just completely inhospitable, and like, it's so weird looking at it now as I'm recording, because like, I noticed there's so much more space, and like, especially like right beside my bed was like the worst situation ever. There were just so many of them that you couldn't even walk around there. Now it's like pretty much entirely clear, and it's so weird just seeing the floor there again. And like, I know people talk about depression rooms, but I never viewed my room as like a depression room, because it was always considered like too neat to be a depression room. But it's made me kind of realize that there's like a scaling to how depression rooms can be. Like, severe depression rooms can like look really, really bad. They can look terrible. But also, you can have severe depression and have a depression room, but it looks for the most part like super neat and organized. And that's kind of because like not all forms of depression look the inherent same. I don't know if any of that made sense. I'm just kind of hoping that people get the general gist of that. But like, it's interesting seeing like how much room there is now. I definitely like got down to the nitty gritty of my collection. Pretty much all the ones that I have left are ones that I personally like enjoy too much and like having so much that I just don't want to get rid of them. And like,
I'm thinking maybe going through my Micromillows in Squishville, but to be fair, a lot of my Micromillows in Squishville are just generally ones that I do also like keeping, so I might not go and do that. I also just realized that I can talk about the literal hellfire that I went through during the Christmas season, because I finally got to work my first Christmas season at the place that I work at, and God, it was terrible. I don't want to ever do that again, but I know that as long as I'm there, I'm gonna have to do it again. And I mean, it's like, it's not terrible, it's just a lot. I mean, a lot in the sense of an autistic person. Like, I know that normally, generally speaking, like, my definition of a lot is a lot more different than how other people see a lot. But when I'm saying a lot, I don't mean just, like, overstimulating for me. I mean it's overstimulating probably for autistics and just neurotypical people. Like, goddamn, especially, like, in that last week leading up to Christmas, it was terrible. Because for, like, general reference, what I'm supposed to do at my job is either cashiering or inventory, which in this case is supposed to be getting out stuff. And during the Christmas season, it's kind of a mishmash of both of these in their most extreme form. We get customer after customer after customer because they're just buying up festive items and all that stuff. Meanwhile, I have to also get boxes out. And in this case, during this end time of like the year and all that stuff, we're getting ready for inventory, which is basically where we have to shove out everything, literally everything, I mean, as much as humanly possible, and then get ready to, like, count it. I probably didn't explain that well whatsoever, but, like, my general point is that basically those last, like, I think 3 weeks of December and into January are basically dealing with over 200 customers, I think. Normally I get, like, just under 200 at maximum, if not like 140 or so. This, like, you get 170 at very minimum, which, like, is a lot of customers, but you get customer after customer. Meanwhile, you're pretty much like trying to shove out as many boxes just as humanly possible, so that way the bag area is like as empty as possible. And then, like, in the first part of January, you as well as pretty much all your other co-workers have to just go by and, like, look at, like, I guess these, like, paper cards that you're supposed to scan and then count the things that are, like, on the shelf and reach, like, a certain quota before you can go move on to the next section. And it's a lot. And better yet, that inventory part's a huge, like, both a huge deal, but also it's kind of a huge bitch, because I think, like, once they get the tags out, you only have half an hour to, like, get all of that quota filled before, like, it just can't be done anymore and you need a new tag. And then in total, I think you get, like, I think a couple of hours, but I will say that that day of inventory was probably the easiest day I've ever had. And then, like, a couple of days after of it was also fairly easy too, because inventory, we, like, finished by 2 and I was supposed to be out by 3. And it was just so weird seeing everyone vanish in the blink of an eye. And then a couple of days later, there was a massive snowstorm and I had to go in. And I also got let out at 2 because, like, no one showed up whatsoever. I mean, no one as in customers in this case. And if that sounds hectic to you, it was. I don't know how else to put it. It just was hectic. But luckily, it's all in the past, and now, like, the last few days have been significantly easier, considering that, like, I don't really have anything to do other than cashiering for the most part. I mean, as of recording this video, I did have to go and reorganize the makeup section that we have, but, like, I got halfway through it before, like, getting out of work, which wasn't too bad. I was expecting to get a lot less done just given how many customers I was getting, but, like, there's not really much that I can do because we pretty much got out every single box that could be gotten out, and so the shelves are utterly stocked and we can't fill anything until we, like, reorganize stuff and see where things can go, and if possible, see, like, what boxes we have that can even go out whatsoever. It has absolutely been a wild ride, but I'm going to let you guys just listen to the music that I have on in the background until you see the part where a really big fuck up happened, because spoilers, the end of this video kind of gets cut off abruptly, because at the time of recording this, my iCloud was not connected to my iPhone, and so around, like, late stage of this drawing, I ended up losing the ability to record because I had to go transfer everything to my iCloud because there wasn't enough storage on my phone anymore. It was terrible. That's one of the bigger reasons why this video took so long, because I just had to get everything in order. But luckily, now I can record again on my phone, which is, like, super great because I want to do more traditional art videos. But yeah, let's get to the point. You get to hear the music until I come back in non-voiceover mode. Goodbye! Well, that was an eventful video, wasn't it? I'm sorry that you didn't get to see the full creation of this because, unfortunately, my photos were not synced to the iCloud. But this is the full product! I very much struggled with giving her a better cutie mark because the cake just was not doing it for me, plus the head got in the fucking way. Also, peep the potential design of Twilight Sparkle in this universe. I will explain it when I get to her. She's probably going to be last, though. I just want to give a big thank you to Grabby, even though I bought these with my own personal money and all that, but I still want to thank the company because I love their watercolors and I really do like these acrylic markers. I've learned a lot just by doing this piece alone, and I'm definitely going to have fun doing the rest of the main six as time goes on, though in saying that I have an idea that the way I'm going to do it is that I'm going to create the traditional versions of them first as a sort of concept and then do them digitally afterward. So after this video gets posted, you will most likely be seeing a digital art version of this character. I just realized I didn't give her any lines to signify she has a mouth. It works on the pony versions, absolutely. Does not work on the human version. Wap, I'll see you around. Goodbye!
I forgot about the bow!